everyone. Thanks for tuning in. Today's theme is happy families. Now, I'd like to think that every family in the world was a happy one, but we know that's not true. But the great news is the Bible doesn't try to cover up those facts. It's real and it's honest. And today's story is about a family that should have been happy, but went wrong somewhere along the way. And the great news is that even when that family was broken and messed up and got things wrong, God was still there to forgive, to transform, and to make things right again. And even if families are broken, it's great to know that we're part of God's family. And God is our Heavenly Father who loves and cherishes us and who's never, ever going to let us down. So tune in, pay attention, and I hope you learn lots and have a lot of fun this morning. Before we start, let's pray. Dear God, thank you so much that you have created families for us to live in and that your intention is that those families should be happy families, families that are good, families that help us to be the people that you want us to be. Sometimes things might go wrong and we just pray that you'll be at the centre of our families. And you'll always help us to remember that you are a perfect Heavenly Father. And if people in our family get things wrong sometimes, we just thank you that you never will. Help us to be the kind of children that bring our families joy, to honour our mother and father, to be kind and patient with our brothers and sisters in all that we do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hello, ELC kids.
Hey, Jill.
Hi, Dawn. How are you?
I'm okay. How are you?
Good, thank you.
Have you heard about this week's competition?
No. What's that?
This week's competition is make a game with your parents that kids can play along to on the broadcast. And those that get shown on the broadcast will win a prize.
I love games, Dawn. What about, could they record a ball game?
Yeah, as long as the kids at home can play it.
What about a football game?
Oh, I love a game.
I love a good football game.
But it has got to be something that's easy that kids can do at home.
Okay.
So something like, Simon said jump up and down.
Oh, sorry.
Simon said put your hands on your head. Sit down. Something like hide and seek, something, I don't know, there's lots of things out there that you know that's better than me. So we want your ideas, we want you to get creative, lots of new games that people can play along to, and those, if yours is shown, a prize will be arriving at your door. So join in and send those videos to me.
Thank you.
Bye.
Hi everyone. So today's story is a story that Jesus told about the lost son. And Jesus said there was once a family. There was a dad and his two sons, and they lived on a farm. And one day the younger son went to his dad and said, "Dad, can I have the money that I'm going to have when I'm older? Because I want to go to the city and I want to go and live my own life." And so the dad said to him, "Well, okay, if you really want to." And he gave him the money. And a few days later, the younger son went off to the city to live his own life, while the older son stayed at home with his dad on the farm to help him look after the farm. Well, it wasn't very long before the younger son had spent all the money that he had. He got nowhere to live, he'd got no food to eat, and he realised he had to go and get a job. But the only job that he could find was looking after the pigs. Well, you can imagine it wasn't a very nice job. It was a bit smelly and not very nice at all. But the boy was so hungry that he even thought about eating some of the food that he was feeding to the pigs. So one day, while he was feeding the pigs, looking after them, he thought, "I've been so silly. Because the people that work for my dad, they have somewhere to live. They have food to eat. My dad pays them for working for him. I could go back to my dad and I could say to him, 'I'm not worthy to be your son anymore, but can I come and work for you?'" And so that's what he decided to do. So the next day he went back, travelled back to his dad's farm. Well, the Bible says that his dad looked out for him every day. Every single day his dad went and he looked down the road to see if his younger son was coming back. And that day he saw him. He saw him down the road walking towards the farm, coming back to him. And his dad was so happy to see him, so excited that he ran down the road towards his son and he threw his arms around him and he gave him a great big hug. And the son said to his dad, "Dad, I'm so sorry. I'm not worthy to be your son anymore, but can I come and work for you?" And his dad said to him, "Don't be silly. You are my son. I love you. It doesn't matter what you've done. You are my son. We're going to have a great big party tonight." And he told his servants to make lots of food and he told them to get lots of nice clothes for his son to put on. And so that's what they did. They had a big party, a celebration to welcome him back with lots of food. Well, the older son was still out in the fields looking after the animals. And when he came back, he heard the music and all the people having a party. And he said to one of the servants, "What's going on?" And the servant said to him, "Your dad is so happy. Because your younger brother has come back. Your younger brother, who your dad thought was lost, he's come back home and your dad's thrown him a great big party to celebrate." And the older brother was so angry. He went to his dad and he said, "Look, you're celebrating that he's come home. He's spent all your money. He's been away in the city. He left. And you're celebrating that he's back. And yet I've been here all the time helping you on the farm and you haven't even given me some food that I can eat and have a little party with my friends." And his dad said to him, "But you've always been here. I knew you were safe. I knew where you were. You know that I love you. Your younger brother, I didn't even know whether he was alive. He was lost. He was gone. I didn't know where he was. And now he's back. And now that is why we're celebrating." Now, sometimes in families, we don't always get on, do we? We maybe have arguments with our brothers and sisters. And we might even have crosswords with our mum and dad sometimes. And that's what it's like in families. But we also belong to God's family. And we know that God loves us. We are part of his family. God loves us. God helps us. Just think how the younger son must have felt when he came back home and how when his dad gave him such a big hug and gave him a party, think how he felt. And yet we also know, think how his older brother felt as well. He was really cross, really, really angry with his dad, because he didn't understand that his dad had been so worried about his younger brother that he was overjoyed when he came back. Also think about how the dad felt. Dad was so happy that his son had come back. He let him go because that's what he wanted it to do. But he was so happy when he came back. And you know what? Jesus is really happy that we are part of his family. Jesus is really happy when we do good things. But you know what? Even if we do things wrong, we're still part of God's family. And God still loves us. It doesn't matter what we do. We're still part of God's family. So think about your families today and over the next week. And maybe say thank you to God for them. Thank you for all that they do for you. Thank you for the love that they show you. Thank him for the care that you have. Thank him that you're safe with your family. And also thank him that we are part of his family as well. And that we know that he really, really loves us no matter what.
Good morning, Friday. Today I will be doing your memory verse, and your memory verse is Proverbs 23, verse 25. What a pleasure a wise child is. So give your parents joy! And that is your memory verse for today. Hope you're having a nice day. Go to the next activity.
Thank you, Holly, for doing this week's memory verse for us. What a pleasure a wise child is. So bring your parents joy. And I've been thinking of this week's craft, how can we bring our parents joy? And I thought, well, one of the things is doing as our parents ask, but another thing is by saying thank you. So today we're going to make thank you booklets. And we don't need very much for this. We just need some paper and some pens, really. I'm using coloured paper, A4, but it's all right if it's all white. That will work equally as well. So what we're going to do is just fold your paper. I'm putting all the sheets together and fold it in half. Crease nicely down there. And straight away, we've got our small little booklet. Now, I've already done one to save a bit of time here. So on the front of your book, you just want to write the words, thank you. And then decorate it, because we want to make this book look really happy and bring people pleasure and joy. So on mine, I'm going to do lots of different colours and sizes of smiley faces, okay? So I'm just going to do a few of those, but you can decorate it with flowers or stars or just patterns, whatever you fancy. Okay, I think I'll just do one more and show you that. So there is the front page of my thank you booklet with smiley faces. Now inside, we need to start saying thank you. So have a think about your family. All our families are different. We might just have a mum or just have a dad at home. We might have both parents. We might be looked after by aunts or uncles. But whoever you want to say thank you to in your family, write their name on the first page. So I've started off with mum. And then I've written at the bottom, thank you for my delicious food and for all your big hugs. But you can say thank you for anything. You want to thank her for washing and ironing your clothes, or just for looking after you when you're poorly, for taking you to school. And whatever you want to thank your mum for, draw a picture. So you can draw a picture of your favourite meal
It could be fish and chips maybe, or something like that, or Sunday roast. Or you might want to draw a picture of your mummy cooking. And then on the next page, I've written Dad. Now, what am I going to do for Dad? On this page, I thought I'd do a picture of Daddy reading a book. Okay, so I'm going to draw a book here. But your daddy might, I don't know, play games with you. You might have lots of fun with your daddy. He might drive you to school, or Daddy might do the cooking. So whatever you want to thank your daddy for, draw a picture. Let's put some pages in this book. I haven't drawn his face on yet, but there's a picture. And I've written, thank you for helping me to learn. I love our time together. So that's a really nice thank you. And then one of the hardest thank yous to do is to brothers and sisters, because I don't think very often we say thank you to them. So let me see, what have I drawn on mine? I've put a name there, Tom, but you obviously put whatever your brother or sister is, if you've got one. And I've drawn a picture of them playing together and saying, thank you for playing with me. We have lots of fun. Okay, well, it might be they share things with you, or they might help you with homework. Then right at the back, I've just written, I meant to put a big heart there, love you. So what I've done is I've cut a heart out and I'm going to glue that in. Okay, so I'll just do that quickly. And that is my thank you booklet. And I think it will make a real difference in your family. It will make your family very happy that you said thank you. And it will be something that they can keep. So when this is finished, get your paper and pens out and make your thank you booklet. And I thought it would be really good now, right at the end, to do our memory verse together again. So this time, I want you to join in with Holly, do your smiley face, being wise, and see if you can jump the highest at the end. Okay then, see you soon. Bye.
And your memory verse is Proverbs 23, verse 25. What a pleasure a wise child is. So give your parents joy! And that is your memory verse for today.
It's game time! Are you ready? Fantastic. This game is a bit like hide and seek, but I'm going to call it hide and go find, because we're not finding people, we're going to find objects or maybe sweets. So what we need to do is go and get your favourite thing or favourite sweets. And what's Amelia's? Who's this?
Teddy!
Amelia's this pink teddy. So go and get yours, and then the family has got to go and find you once you've hit it. So, where's our family? Where's your mummy?
There!
There she is! Come on then! So, me and Katie, Amelia's mummy, is going to go and find pink teddy, but Amelia's got to go and hide it. So, you're going to go and hide it?
Yeah.
Go on then, you go and hide it. Go and hide your teddy. Amelia's going to go and hide the teddy, and then we're going to go and find you. But if you can't find it as a family, it doesn't matter, because Jesus still loves you, because you're all part of one family. So if you're with your mummies, your daddies, your aunties, your uncles, your carers, you all, I want you all to participate. So yeah, come on family, you've got to participate in this game. Have you hit it?
Yeah.
Well, we're going to go and find the teddy. You go and hide yours. See you later. Bye.
Gracious to you, the Lord turn his face toward
all, I hope you've enjoyed today's session. We've learned today that families are not always happy families, but we have a Heavenly Father who we can always rely on, who is always with us and will always love us no matter what. I bet you've all heard that saying, you can choose your friends, but you can't choose your family. Sometimes families are just like that, but our Heavenly Father loves us no matter what. And let's pray. Father God, I thank you for this session and I thank you for everybody who's joined in. I pray that each and every child will know your love, know your surrounding, know your understanding. I pray that they will know that you are always with them no matter what. And I pray that they will feel loved and know that you are a loving Father. In your wonderful name we pray. Amen.